Millions of people remain trapped in the capital of Sudan as vicious fighting now enters its third week. A tenuous truce between military rivals was supposed to allow civilians to flee, but that hasn't held, leaving many battling to stay alive in the war-torn country.
This is now life in Sudan, a daily mission of dodging rockets and airstrikes from above. A smoky haze hovers over the capital, Khartoum, the crack of gunshots piercing the air, the sound of a ceasefire being broken. That's despite both military factions battling for control of the country, agreeing to extend a truce by another 3 days. The streets are desolate, littered by the wreckage of fights previous and signs of a country descending into all-out civil war. Not even the central bank was spared. The truce, which was brokered by intense diplomatic efforts of the US, the UK and the United Nations, was to be used to evacuate civilians. 2,000 aboard the Amana ferry are the latest to make it to safety.
If you're ready to leave, they just put you in a ship.
But for most, the path out was not easy, as our CBS News colleague Remy Innocencio discovered when he greeted the ship.
They're going to call us back. And we're waiting for calls and nobody call us.
No one call us.
And we just, after 4 days, and we start calling the embassy, and then the phone is nobody answers. I mean, it's out of service because they closed there.
When you were calling the embassy and no one picked up and the line...
Well, we feel like terrible. We couldn't even know what to do.
While some are too young to understand Sudan's suffering right now, the pain may still haunt them for years to come.
Sometimes I just feel like when I'm leaving, I feel like a traitor to my country. I'm leaving them in all this pain while I'm going to go and have joy.
It's a heavy cross to bear for Abdullah, but help is coming for his countrymen and women, with the first Red Cross aid flight arriving. The priority, ensuring supply doesn't stop as millions of people remain trapped.
We've had humanitarian workers be under attack as well, with some deaths along the way. So the conditions are extremely, extremely, extremely dangerous.
And as the conflict enters its third week, those conditions are only likely to get worse. Dom Halen for 10 News First.